In this, the final section for math for physics, we're going to look at calculations and significant digits. When we're dealing with measurements, we have to have new set of rules for adding and subtracting measurements, for multiplying and dividing measurements, because these numbers aren't just regular numbers, they're measurements that have a certain level of accuracy, and we have to make sure that we're always as accurate as our least accurate number. We cannot report our answer to anything more accurate than our least accurate starting number. So we're going to learn two rules, one for addition and subtraction, and one for multiplication and division. For addition and subtraction, we round off our answer to the same number of decimal places as there were in the number with the least number of decimal places originally. So take a look at the example, 9.54 plus 3.2. If we punch this into our calculator, we end up with 9.54 plus 3.2 is 12.74. Now, one common question that students often ask their science teachers or their math teachers is, how many decimal places do you want? And the answer to that only comes after understanding significant digits and accuracy, and the answers depend on what the starting measurements were. So when adding and subtracting numbers, we report our answer to the same number of decimal places as there were in the number with the least number of decimal places. So 9.54 had two decimal places and 3.2 had one decimal place. So we have to make sure that we report it to the same number as the least number of decimal places, which is one decimal place. So this becomes 12.7 meters. And remember to round with the rules that you've learned for rounding in the previous video. Now, when multiplying and dividing, we're no longer looking at decimal places. The rules for multiplying and dividing measurements states that we round off the answer to the same number of significant digits as there were in the number with the least number of significant digits originally. So start by just multiplying 9.54 times 3.2, put it in your calculator, and you get this long number, 30.528. Now, we can't leave it like that. We have to report it to the same number of significant digits as there were in the number with the least number of significant digits. So 9.54 has three significant digits, and 3.2 has two significant digits. So we have to write this to two significant digits. So we have to drop all three of these numbers. If we do, we end up rounding up because it's a 5 followed by other numbers, 2 and an 8. So we end up with 31 meters squared. All right. Those are the two most important rules. The next comes when adding numbers written in scientific notation. When adding numbers in scientific notation, you're best to express the numbers as the same power of 10. Now, let's look at this example. 1.4 times 10 to the power of 2 plus 2.3 times 10 to the power of 3. 1 is to the power of 2 and 1 is to the power of 3. We have to express them both as the same power. So we either write them both as 10 to the power of 2 or both to 10 to the power of 3. I suggest, and here's my little hint, always use the lower exponent. So we're going to keep the first one as 1.4 times 10 to the power of 2, but I'm going to rewrite this as an exponent to the power of 2 instead. So I want to decrease the exponent. If I decrease the exponent, remember, moving the decimal left increases exponent, and moving it right decreases the exponent. So if I want this exponent to go down from 3 to 2, I got to move the decimal place over one spot to the right. So this becomes 1.4 times 10 to the power of 2 plus 23 times 10 to the power of 2. So I move the decimal place over one spot to the right, and the exponent goes down one spot, so it becomes 23 times 10 to the power of 2. Now, once they're both in the same power, then you use the rules for addition and subtraction. And the rules for addition and subtraction up above told us to look at the decimal places. So 1.4 has one decimal place, and 23 has no decimal places. If you punch this into your calculator, you end up with 24.4 times 10 to the power of 2, but we have to report it to no decimal places because this guy had no decimal places. So we just end up with 24 times 10 to the power of 2. Now, we can't just leave it that way because it's not in proper scientific notation. We got to get that decimal place to the right of the first non-zero digit, like we always do with scientific notation. So after you're done doing that conversion, put it back into proper scientific notation. This becomes 2.4. Now, when you move the decimal place over to the left, the exponent goes up. So this becomes 2.4 times 10 to the power of 3. Okay, if there is an operation that has addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, or any combination, you always default to the rules for multiplying and dividing. All right, here are some sample calculations that deal with adding and subtracting, multiplying and dividing, and a combination of adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing. Good luck.